Hello YouTube. Here's a brief and not very in-depth tutorial for LWC commands and a few essential commands. We'll start off with LWC. LWC is a chest protect program, but it also protects other things like dispensers, doors, furnaces, and signs. So let's set these up. Okay. Now, there's different commands that do different things. The first command is /c public with no spaces, and you'll get the chat down there. It'll tell you the lock type, and then it'll tell you left click on the block you want to lock. So then I'll click on the chest, and now this chest is locked, but it's set to public, so basically anybody can get into it. So I don't know why they have that kind of command, but I guess they do. Now let's say you put the wrong lock type and you want to get rid of that. You type /c remove, enter, click the chest or door, whatever you put the wrong lock on, and it'll remove that. The next type is /c private, and what this does is if you just type /c private and you click on a chest, you'll be the only one who can open that locked item. Now let's say you wanted to add somebody on there. You type /lwc space hyphen M space and then a random name, or like whatever name of the person you want to add. Then you press enter, click on them, and then now it'll also register the rights for the person or group that you do. You can also add groups, but it's usually mainly for mods really, but you would do /lwc space hyphen M space colon G for groups space, and then put mods or whatever, and then now only moderators can get into the moderators, and then anybody else you list. So let's remove this. Now you can add people all at once instead of having to set it to private and then keep adding people. You would just type /c private space your name space anybody else and then anybody else's name. So I'm adding two other people along with myself, so now it's locked for everybody else except those three players. Those three players can get into this chest. Then there's another command called /c password. And what this does is it creates a password for the chest. So what you would do is you type /c password space and then whatever password you want. So I'm just going to make it LOL. Enter. Click on that. And then it'll create a chest that's locked unless you put the password in. Now it'll give you a text that says, for your convenience, you don't have to enter your password until your next login, which is kind of cool. So let's try to log in here. No. Anyways. But yeah, /c remove. What else? Oh. Then you have two modes that are actually quite useful. You have /lwc space mode space persist and /lwc space mode space drop transfer. What persist does is if you have a lot of chests that you just want to make private, or you want to make private and then add people on, you would type /lwc space mode space persist and then press enter, and now whatever command you type after this will be the command that follows. So if I wanted to make the chest, the furnace, and the door private, I would just type slash C private, enter, click the chest, click the furnace, click the door, and now they're all, oh, that's weird, they're all locked. And then just type slash LWC space remove mode, or remove modes, excuse me, and it'll take it off. Sometimes, like, you have to click one more time because it'll still have, like, the persist mode. But just click on something that you've already locked and then it'll go away. So let's see. Slash C, remove. Slash C, remove. It's just a good command that way you don't have to keep typing it over and over again. Actually, hold on. Let's slash C, private. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about the drop transfer. So I've made the chest private to me. Now I'm going to type slash LWC space mode space drop transfer. There's no space in the drop transfer. Space select. And what I'm doing is I'm selecting the target chest that I want this command to target. So now this chest is selected as my drop transfer target. Now I'm going to type slash LWC space mode space drop transfer, as I'm spelling it wrong, space on, press enter. Now it's turning it on. So now this chest will be the drop transfer target. And what drop transfer does is, no matter where you are or how far you are, if you have a chest selected and you have it on, whenever you press your drop button, whatever you drop will automatically be put into this chest. So you can see I have 9 pieces of dirt, and I'm dropping them. Now let's walk over to the chest. There's the 9 plus the few extra that I dropped. So I'll show that to you again, except we'll go over here. So now you can see we're this far away. I've dropped all of them. Just walk back over here. And now it's in here. So no matter how far you are, it'll drop whatever you drop, it'll put it into this chest. Now you can type, now to turn this off, you type slash LWC space mode space drop transfer off. And now drop transfer is off. And let's say you had another chest that you wanted to target, you would just type slash LWC space mode space drop transfer space select, and then click on that, left click on that chest. And that's it for the LWC part of the video. Now I'm going to explain some of the essential commands. So let's go up into here. The first one is it's actually really useful. So let's go up here. Alright. So, you know, whenever you, it's always a hassle that when you die or when you want to go back to your house, you have to, you know, walk all the way back to your house. Well, with essentials, there's a command where you can set wherever you're standing as your home point, which is basically your spawn, and you can teleport to that home point and or spawn with a certain command. So if you type slash set home, no spaces, and click enter, it'll say home set. So as you can see, I just set my home. So let's go outside and jump down here. So now I'm down here. Slash, now if you type slash home and press enter, it'll teleport you to wherever your home point, wherever you set your home. Which is very, very useful. And whenever you die, you'll be sent to that wherever you set your home. Now, you can also warp to certain places if your server has any warps. So you would type slash warp space and then the name of whatever warp. In this case, I'll use a warp that we already have. So I'll type in GM tower. So slash warp space and then the name of the warp, in this case GM tower, and it'll warp me to the it'll warp me to the inside of this place, which, why are there trees in here? But anyways, so you can do slash home, and now I'm all the way back at home. Another minor command too is slash AFK. It just sets yourself AFK. It just, like, basically says that you're AFK. Slash AFK. It says GM Shinji is now AFK. You type it again and you are no longer AFK. Slash me space, like, and any message. So I'll type slash me space is space asleep, and it'll say GM Shinji is asleep. It's just like an emote type command. There's slash list, which shows everybody that's online, and if they're AFK, it'll have AFK in capital letters and also in brackets next to that name. Slash help OP space and then any message, it'll display help OP and then the person's name and then their message. Slash mail read will, if you have any mail and you type this, it'll bring up the last or the newest message. If you type slash mail space send space a character name and then space your message, so it'll send that message to that person, and they would type slash mail read slash mail space read to read that message. Now let's say you have like a message and you've already read it and you want to get rid of it. You type slash mail space clear and it'll say mail cleared. You can also whisper people slash tell or slash MSG. For slash tell, it'd be slash tell space their name space and then a random message. Or you could type slash MSG their name and then a message. Slash tell is actually the server command and slash MSG is the essentials command, but they work the same way. Then the last three commands are slash get POS, which is short for get position, and it'll tell you your coordinates. Then you type slash depth, and it'll tell you how many blocks you are above sea level. And the last one is slash compass, and it'll tell you which direction you're facing. So I'm facing east now. I changed direction, slash compass. Now I'm facing south. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed this video, and hopefully you found these commands useful. Later.